Hello and welcome to my channel Spark Stenographer. Today I am going to deliver you a shortened dictation from Kailash Chandra magazine volume number 12 and the transcription number 262. So guys, ready for the dictation? 10 seconds. 5 seconds. Start. This bill forms the last part of the budget proposals which the finance minister introduced on the 15th May this year. The other parts of which, such as the finance bill, the wealth tax bill and the railway passenger fares bill, have already been passed by this house. During the general discussion in May last, as well as during the discussion last week in this house on the finance and health tax bills, the finance minister explained at length the objective of our taxation policy and the features of the integrated tax structure we are trying to evolve through these measures. I need not traverse the same ground again, except to stress that the bill now before the House forms an essential component of this integrated scheme of taxation. The purpose of this measure is, as I have already stressed, threefold. Firstly, it is undoubtedly the augmentation of public revenues to the extent this measure is capable of doing so. Secondly, which in my opinion is even more important, it is to reduce the excessive consumer spending and divert the surplus funds towards savings. And lastly, together with the wealth tax and the Income Tax Acts, it would provide an effective weapon to counter tax evasion and avoidance. Before I take the House through the provisions of this bill as passed by the Lok Sabha, I may say that the scheme of expenditure tax has not been without advocate support, not only in the other house but also among the public at large. Undoubtedly, we had to face some oppositions and circumstance, but the criticism was not one-sided. There were those who argued that the measure did not go far enough and that is gave so far too many concessions and exemptions. There were others who wanted these concessions and exemptions to be enlarged, and yet others, though they were comparatively few, who objected to this measure in principle on the ground that this measure has not been tried elsewhere, that it would lead to an inquisitive probe of a person's private life and that it would cause undue harassment. About this question of harassment, the finance minister talked at length the other day in the other house. I am mentioning it only to say that the select committee had this question of possible harassment in their mind, and it was with a view to ensuring that no harassment was caused. The Lok Sabha has given its approval to all the changes proposed by the Select Committee and in addition made certain further modifications through of a comparatively minor character. In this way, the bill as passed by the Lok Sabha has emerged as a somewhat lighter measure than the original bill, and I do hope that it has thereby become more acceptable to those who would come within its purview. I shall now proceed to describe briefly the important differences between the bill as originally introduced and the bill as passed by the Lok Sabha. One of the most important changes made in the bill is to the proviso to clause 3. As honorable members are aware, the original bill had provided that no expenditure tax would be payable if the total income under the Income Tax Act for the relevant previous year did not exceed rupees 1 lakh. A good deal of thought was given to this provision in the bill, and the Lok Sabha also debated at some length on the pros and cons of such a provision. As in the case of many other provisions of this bill, extremely divergent views were expressed. Some wanted that the proviso should be omitted altogether. Others wanted that it should stand as originally proposed, while some others wanted to lower the limits of income proposed. There were also a few who suggested that the limit should be higher. Finally, we came to the conclusion that at least in the initial stages of the working of a few measures like this, a provision of this nature was necessary, because on the one hand, it would make the administration of the act somewhat easier, and on the other hand, it would ensure that the assessee would not normally come within its scope, is not unnecessarily troubled. It was felt, however, that no distinction was necessary between income liable to income tax and that which was not so liable, because the proper criterion was not income as defined in the Income Tax Act, but income or receipts from all sources, including casual and non-recurring receipts that would remain with a person after meeting all his tax liabilities. Accordingly, the proviso as passed by the Lok Sabha restricts the levy of expenditure tax to some persons whose net income, that is, the income remaining after paying the tax from all sources during the any year, exceeds rupees 80,000. This limit was fixed with due regard to the basic allowances of rupees 50,000, so that any person with an income of rupees 50,000 would have to pay expenditure tax. Stop.